What's up, guys? Nick Davis with 239 Flies, and today we are actually not going to be using the device at all. I'm going to show you how to make my crustacean eyes. You guys have been wondering for a while now how I do this, and you know, there's a couple different ways to do it. I'm going to show you the easiest and most foolproof way to make some killer eyes. Without further ado, I got some Mason Hard Mono. This is a pack of 16 pound. We're actually not going to use that. We're going to use 40. And with this Mason Hard Mono, it's not very pliable. It's really stiff and really rigid. And in these packs too, that they come here, there's a lot less memory because it's a much wider, you know, diameter, which, you know, makes it nice for when you're tying it on, you know, making some nice crustaceans. So I'm gonna cut them into like, I don't know, 3.5, 4 inches. And you can do as many of these at a time. This is 3.5, 4 inches, the hard mono. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take it. And if you're inside doing this, it's a lot easier. But and burn a little bead on it. Very careful to not let that drip on your finger. Ask me how I know. Make sure these are good and cool down before you set them down. Otherwise, they're gonna stick and not be round when you pick them back up. All right, so now that we've got 6 or 7 of these things made. Now, like I said, you can make as many of these as you want. And the beauty of this Loon UV glue is that whenever it gets hit with a UV light is when it hardens. So you can load this thing up with eyes and harden them all at once. And you can mix up, you know, what you want to do and as far as, you know, flavors go. I got my handy dandy New Wave dryer. This thing, I've got about half a century's worth of use simulated on it. I might have dropped it 10 times. We start with the UV clear fly finish thick. Very important to go with the thick. I'm going to show you how to start this here. Let's take the mono, dip it in, do the other side. And hit the button. Now this step's really important if you have a dryer, because if you just go ahead and put the glue on there and zap it with the light or put it in the sunlight, it's going to cure how it's on there. Give it a few revolutions, it'll give it time to even out and ball up and make a nice symmetrical eye. Now if you didn't have a New Wave dryer, what you can do is twirl it like this, nice and slow, a few times for it to coat around, hold it in the light. These are nice and cured. Now dip it back. Dip it in there again. There we go, a couple go rounds. Let it even out. Now we take it and stick it back over in the light. And now we've got some clear eyes. And as you can see, there's no tack. They're not soft, they're hard. Nice, even, symmetrical, same size eyes, which is pretty key. Does it matter when you're catching fish? No. Does it matter when you show your friends how awesome a fly tire you are? Bet your ass it does. Now, we can give these things some color. We can do this one of a couple different ways. I'm going to show you how to use the Loon Hardhead Black. And this stuff's pretty cool. This isn't a UV glue. This is like a water-based dye, almost. It makes like a nice film on the fly. And just dip it in here. Dab it off. Dab it off. Stick it back on the dryer and let it go around. You can either leave this on there for some pretty cool little effect, or You just take your scissors, go around it, and pull it off right at the eye for no little stem.
That's how you would make black ones, is you can do them all that way. You could use pink. I know they've got orange. You got some clear ones too. You can mix some of these pigments in there. I'm gonna use some of the phosphorescent, or in other words, glow in the dark, which is pretty awesome. It'll make glow in the dark makeup, unfortunately. Otherwise, I would have bought stock in it. You don't have to use a ton of this stuff because it's a really high quality powder. It mixes really well, it coats really well. Dip that in once. Dip that in twice. Like I said, this stuff isn't a UV product, so it needs a few minutes to dry. Let this go around and around a few times. Another cool trick for doing these is take a dark color. I've got chocolate brown here. I think this is the first time I've actually used this. They make black. They make a ton of different colors. I don't even have all the colors that I have here with me. You can really get carried away and have some fun. So I'm going to take this, get you a little pile of it. Mix in your color. Ooh, looks like brownie batter. That sounds delicious. Get this in here like this. And let that go around and around a few times. Now, put this back over here. Let's put the cap back on this. Get you a little more on there. Now, we'll leave it clear. Leave the second coat clear. For a pretty cool little pupil effect. You can also do that with this. Dip that a few times into that and let it dry. And that makes it really cool. And you can get these things in any color. And they are pretty sweet. Not to mention you can mix them in with some glue and put them on the bottom or top of crab shells for crab flies for shells, which I'm sure we'll get to in a later episode. Right, so I hope that answers some of your questions and you're a little more informed on how these are made now. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up on the website, 239flies.com, and I'll try to answer any more you might have. Until then, good luck, have some fun, tie a few on,